The Kazam Tornado 348 is a 4G 4.8-inch Android smartphone from a British-based company set up by former HTC execs that briefly held the mantle of the world's slimmest phone until the 4.85mm thick Oppo R5 turned up. Slender design aside, it's very much a mid-range range phone. Its 720p HD display and 8-megapixel camera mark it out as much, but its 8-core MediaTek processor suggests it might have a little more grunt than most mid-range phones. This £250 phone achieves its goal of delivering a sleek and stylish phone at an affordable price. However, while it's stylish, it lacks a really killer feature that would convince us to choose this over more illustrious rivals, and lags many where camera quality is concerned. The super slim frame is the major talking point here, but there's no escaping the similarities with certain Apple and Sony phones, either. The champagne gold metal trim and slightly curved corners echo the iPhone 5's and iPhone 6, while the flat glass rear reminds us of the Sony Xperia Z3 and other Z series phones. The trim does have a flatter, cooler anodized finish to it that gives the 348 its own character, but Kazam has clearly taken inspiration from those phones. That's by no means a bad thing, though, and while it doesn't feel as nice to hold as Apple's more delicate curves, it's in no way uncomfortable. What's more, the build quality doesn't suffer too much for being so thin. At 5.15mm thick, it's thinner than the iPhone 6, 7.1mm, and the Samsung Galaxy S5, 7.6mm, by some distance. It's light too, just 95 grams, so much so you'll barely notice it in your pocket. In the few weeks we spent with it, we saw no worrying flex in the body, and the metal and glass materials ensure it doesn't feel cheap or tacky. The slender bezel around the sides of the screen give it that nice 16:9 ratio for films, with capacitive Android buttons below the screen. The button placement on the 348 is similar to iPhones, too. The headphone jack lies at the bottom edge next to the micro USB charging port, with the micro SIM card slot on the right and the chrome metal volume rocker and standby button on the left. The 348 features a 4.8-inch AMOLED display that, combined with the super slim body, makes this an easy phone handle in one hand. It's not the best 720p display we've seen, but it's solid enough performer for everyday tasks. Its 720p HD resolution makes it about as sharp as similarly priced phones, like the Moto G. That's fine, as full HD displays aren't common at this price, the Honor 6 being a notable exception. This equates to 306 ppi, pixels per inch, which is ample to ensure good clarity for text and images. The AMOLED panel means colors are vibrant and blacks very deep, too, which is perfect for watching films. Much like the AMOLED screens on Samsung's phones, however, these colors can look a little oversaturated out of the box. There isn't any special display modes to tinker with to improve matters, either. You won't have many problems viewing this at night, while outdoor visibility is strong with only some minor glare issues. Sadly, there's no Android 5.0 lollipop love here for the Tornado 348, as Kazam opts for Android 4.4.2 KitKat. It's a lightly skinned version of Google's mobile operating system, so you don't have to deal with too many unique idiosyncrasies. That said, there are some, and Kazam's minor tweaks don't alter the experience for the good. The notifications panel is set up differently, where settings and notifications are separated into two tabs. Instead of display brightness living inside the notifications tab, it's been moved to live within the settings. The 348 runs on a MediaTek TrueOcta MT6592 processor with a not-so-impressive 1GB of RAM. In theory, it should handle Ultra HD/4K video playback, and although the Tornado doesn't support that video recording resolution, it's impressive for a phone of this price to be capable of playing 4K video. The main benefits of an octa-core processor should be to improve multitasking and gaming performance without having a substantial impact on power consumption, and it's among the faster phones at this price. The Tornado runs swiftly and with no discernible lag during everyday use. Taking care of your photos and selfies are a front and rear facing camera that don't excel in any single way at night or day. At the back is an 8-megapixel camera sensor with an LED flash, but no high-end goodies like optical image stabilization to improve low-light shooting. Up front is a 5-megapixel camera that's more than adept at taking sharp, albeit still slightly noisy images, but is perfectly suited for video calls in well-lit environments. The Tornado includes a non-removable 2050mAh battery, which we found capable of getting you through a day but not much more than that. There are no power-saving modes to push things further and you will certainly want to top up before you go to bed if you want to make it through another day. It just about passes our minimum expectation, then, but as it has a non-removable battery you're bound to have problems in future as the battery loses capacity. We'd be very surprised if it lasted a day comfortably after a year of use. The speaker at the back of the phone is pretty average, though. There's decent clarity but it's severely lacking any kind of warmth, especially when you are watching video. Plug a pair headphones in and things don't sound any prettier. Audio quality all feels quite hollow, making this a poor choice if you value audio quality. While there's nothing inherently wrong with the Kazam Tornado 348, it's difficult to come up with something that it really excels over its rivals. This is a £250 mid-range phone, that's super slim but not much else. It's got a good, but not fantastic screen, battery life that will get you through a day and there's enough power to keep things running slick. For the same money, you can get more. The OnePlus One is the first alternative that springs to mind. It's £229.99 and although a little more difficult to get hold of and has a bigger 5.5-inch screen, it's a more complete package.